वेलकम स्टूडेंट, नाउ आई शैल यू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द डेफिनेशन, फीचर्स एंड क्लासिफिकेशन. ओके, आई शैल एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द डेफिनेशन, फीचर्स एंड क्लासिफिकेशन. First of all, you know about the taxonomic retrospect of phylum Platyhelminthes. You know the Carlos Linnaeus. He was the taxonomist. He explained in his book Systema Naturae in 1735. Okay? And created a phylum. And in that phylum, he kept those species which are belonging under your Platyhelminthes. And made one name of the phylum in there. They call as Vermes. Vermes. Called as Vermes. In which he included all invertebrates except the insects. Insects are generally belonging under the where? In the arthropod. And that phylum is called as Arthropoda. Okay? And in Vermes, he kept all types of what? The animals which are remaining in the soil or also in water and make or made what? The disease. Okay? And these are the causing agent of the disease and they are generally performing the parasitic mode of life. Okay? And that phylum would be remaining in that time in the name of the what? Vermes, V-R-M-E-S. However, in the 13th, at the System Naturae in 1788, all flatworms were placed under the order your Intestina. In particular order that is called as Intestina. Okay? But Lamarck in 1860 differentiated in the what? The worms or vermes, or then you say the worms would be depicted as two groups, flat worms and round worms. Flat worms would be remaining under the Platyhelminthes, round worms would be belonging under the Nematohelminthes or Asthelminthes. Okay? But Vogt, V-O-G-T, Vogt, V-O-G-T, the name of the scientist, Vogt, in 1851, he declared the Platyhelminthes would be called as your Platyhelmia. Platyhelmia. However, the scientist, the Gegenbaur, in 1859, and first coined the name of the Platyhelminthes and also divided the entire phylum Platyhelminthes into four different classes. I mentioned the name of the classes in the topmost part of the blackboard. You reveal properly on the blackboard upper surface. You find the four naming in there. One is called as Turbellaria. called as Parmigiana, T-U-R-B-E-L-L-A-R-I-A. Second term is known as Trematoda, T-R-E-M-A-T-O-D-A, Trematoda. Third one is known as Cystoda, C-E-S-T-O-D-O-A. Okay, Cystoda, C-E-S-T-O-D-A, Cystoda. And fourth one is called as Nemertia, Nemertia, N-E-M-E-R-T-E-A, Nemertia. Understand? What are the classes of the platyhelminths according to the scientist your what? The Gegenbaum in 1859. And Gegenbaum in 1859 classified the entire platyhelminths in four different classes. They are named as Carbillaria, then Trematoda, then you find Cystoda, lastly you know what? Nemertia. What is the definition of the phylum platyhelminthes? No doubt the platyhelminthes are the living organisms and they are multicellular by nature and they are usually possesses the three germ layers in the body wall. They call as the triploblastic and there is no definite coelomic cavity. So you can say to them a coelomate. And the body is not segmented, you can say unsegmented. And entire body is bilaterally symmetrical and multicellular form. Okay, bilaterally symmetrical and metazoans, but without anus. Anus is lacking in this form. And there is no circulatory system also. Okay, there is no anus, no circulatory system. However, they possess a mouth and protonephridia system. Okay, protonephridia, you know? The plain cells, which would be helping the process of excretion, and entire body generally comprising the parenchyma tissues and having the spiral type of cleavage development in there. Okay, and by these characteristics, you can differentiate the platyhelminthes from other group of animals. Let us come to know about the characteristic features of the phylum platyhelminthes. What are the characters generally exhibited by the organisms of platyhelminthes? Okay, phylum platyhelminthes are triploblastic, acoelomate means without a body cavity and bilaterally symmetrical animals. Body of this animal would be cut in the two halves, two identical halves. Okay, and they are identical. And second character, body worm-like, but varies from elongated flattened shape to long ribbon-like forms. Body is soft, unsegmented, and dorsoventrally flattened. Okay, fourth point, metameric segmentation and skeletal structure in any form are absent. Okay, there is no skeletal forms in their bodies. There is no endoskeleton, there is no exoskeleton. Okay, however, thus your pseudo metamerism is seen in some members like your Eucystoda. Anterior end of the body is differentiated into the head. Body is covered by epidermis, which is soft and ciliated in case of the your Turbillaria. While in the rest classes like the Trematoda or also Monogenia or Cystoda. Okay, Cystoda, in there is what? Non-ciliated body covering and that outer lining layer must be called as your tegument or you can say integument layer. Okay, and that is present very what? Better manner in there. Tegument is present. And mouth is single opening of the digestive tract and the anus is absent. Before I stated to you, there is no anus, only the mouth is there. In other words, digestive systems is also be remaining as the incomplete form. There is no complete alimentary canal or digestive system. The digestive system is totally absent in case of the Cystoidea. Cystoidea. The Cystoda, which is called Cystoda, that is also called as Cystoidea. C CESTOIDEA. Okay, and there is no alimentary canal, there is no gut, there is no digestive system, that means, okay, and that is lacking. Next, and your axilla and the digestive canal is branched and a tubular ends. That means at the distal it is blindly ended. Entire space between the outer body wall and the gut is filled with your mesenchyme tissues, usually called that is parenchyma. Respiratory and circulatory systems are totally absent because most of the species are generally performing the parasitic mode of life. They will be dependent upon others for their sustenance. There is no need of the circulatory system and also be what? Your respiratory system in their place. The nervous system is most primitive type and is formed by the longitudinal nerve cords with a pair of cerebral ganglia or brain. Sense organs are of common occurrence in your turbil area. In other case, these are very poorly developed or absent. The respiratory system consists of your protonephridia with flame cells, your axilla, your protonephridia are absent. The organism is called as axilla. In there is no protonephridia. Okay? This group is called as axilla, A-C-O-E-L-A. In axilla there is no flame cells or protonephridia. That is lacking. Okay? Or absent. They are generally hermaphroditic, but the Dignian flux are your gonochoristic. Okay? Gonochoristic spelling G-O-N-O-C-H-O-R-I-S-T-I-C. Gonochoristic. Separate sexes. The reproductive system is highly evolved or complex in most of the forms. Fertilization is internal, cleavage spiral and determinant type in some species. Development may be direct or indirect. Life cycle complicated and involves one or more hosts. And flat hosts. All the members are the hosts and usually they are flat in the construction, dorsoventrally compressed. Flat hosts are either free living like the turbilarians or internal or external parasites like the trematodes, cystodes and monogenians, and these three groups of the organisms are performing the parasitic mode of life, and only your turbilarians are maintaining the free living life. Okay, and today I shall already explain about the characteristic features of platyhelminthes organisms to you.